Hi, Nicole and Albert here again with the Relax My Dog vlog. We're here every week answering all of your doggy questions. Last week we covered what to expect when your dog is pregnant, so this week we're going to be covering what to expect when your litter of puppies are born. There is a lot of care that goes into puppies' development, especially in the first couple of weeks. But it's the first few days of a puppy's life that are truly critical, and sometimes as many as several from a litter can die. This is sometimes due to the mother dog accidentally smothering their puppies. The best way to improve the odds of all of your puppies is to make sure that there's someone watching the litter and the mother 24 hours a day. Now, the best way to do this is to make sure that you've worked out a shift pattern before the litter arrives. Both mother and puppies need undisturbed time for themselves, and the best way to do this is to create a den for them before the litter arrives. Many breeders will opt for a whelping box, but all you need is a fenced off area where both mother and puppies can feel safe in their own environment. This den will need to be filled with warm blankets and pillows to make sure that it's warm and inviting for them. All of this bedding will need changing and washing daily, as cleanliness is one of the most important things for the health of your puppies. We can't stress how important it is to keep your puppies warm, especially in their first few weeks. A newborn's temperature should be between 94 and 99 degrees Fahrenheit. Make sure you're regularly checking their temperature. At about the age of 2 weeks, their temperature should rise to about 100 degrees Fahrenheit. You may need to help your puppy begin to nurse, as they are born both blind and deaf. Ensuring your hands are clean and disinfected, carefully pick up the puppy and place it against the mother's nipple. Usually the puppy will smell the milk and latch on, however it may be that you have to gently open her mouth and guide her towards the nipple. Typically puppies will need to feed once every couple of hours in their first 2 to 3 weeks. As you can imagine, this puts a lot of strain on the mother. Sometimes, because of the demand from her puppies, there isn't a lot of nutrition left for her. Therefore, it is critical that she gets extra calcium, protein, and water to help sustain herself and her puppies. Calcium is the most important thing that your mother dog will need. For this, you can use a calcium supplement for pets. Don't use cow's milk, as they cannot digest the lactic acid. You need to be weighing your puppies once every day at least, and keeping a record of the weights. We recommend using a postal scale for this at least once every day for the first 3 weeks of their life. Keeping a record of their weight will make sure that you know that your puppies are healthy and that they are getting all of the necessary nutrition. At about 4 weeks, they are no longer considered as newborns. It's natural for them to start exploring their mother's food, to be wandering around, and to be exploring their different surroundings. At 7 weeks, your puppies should be fully weaned, and at 8 weeks, they'll be ready to leave their mum and find their forever home. So there you have it, our most frequently asked questions about a brand new litter of puppies. We really hope that you enjoyed the video today. If you did, give us a big thumbs up, and if you haven't subscribed, then make sure you do so that you can hear all of our future vlogs. If there's anything in particular you'd like us to cover on the next vlog, then please do let us know in the comments section below. We really love hearing your suggestions. So from me and Albert here at Relax My Dog, we'll see you again next week. Bye! Bye. Now, we recommend feeding your dog puppy food while she is pregnant because it's formulated for growth. Your vet will make recommendations based on your dog's individual needs, but usually they won't need any special nutrients or supplements. Mm-hmm.